Hello guys, this is Shivam back again with CSI and GRF topic wise explanations. So today on the special request of one of our viewer, that is Abhipsa Chakravarti, I am going to explain topic wise important points from oceanography as well as atmospheric sciences. So today I am going to explain oceanic currents. It is one of the important topics of oceanography. So without wasting your time, let's begin. Now what is ocean currents and how it is different from waves and tides? So basically, ocean currents is a continuous directed movement of seawater that can be generated by a number of forces acting upon the water, including wind, Coriolis effect, breaking waves, temperature and salinity difference. Now how it is different from waves? So the basic difference between waves and the currents are, currents are the moving energy as well as mass, while waves are the movement of or the transfer of energy, not mass. So in the case of a wave, only the energy moves in a forward direction or backward direction without movement of water particle. Okay, now these ocean currents are like a river flow in the oceans. They are represent a regular volume of water in a definite path and direction. Okay, now ocean currents are influenced by two types of forces, that are primary, which is initiated by movement of water, and a secondary, which is influenced by the current to flow. Okay, now these primary forces are influence the current by heating of solar energy, wind, gravity and Coriolis forces. Now let's see how heating by solar energy influence the currents. So heating by a solar energy cause water to expand. This kind of expansion is called thermal expansion. So due to this thermal expansion, the density increases and the volume increases. That's why near the equator, the ocean water is about 8 cm higher in level than the middle latitude. This causes a very slight gradient and the water tends to flow down the slope due to the gravitational forces. Now let's see how the wind influence the currents. Here wind means atmospheric circulations. Wind blowing on the surface of ocean pushes the water to move. Friction between the wind and the water surface affects the movement of water body in its course. Winds are responsible for both magnitude and the direction. For example, in the case of monsoon winds, suppose right now it's time of southwest monsoon. So in the Arabian Sea, the movement of currents are in a clockwise direction, like Somali currents, West India current, etc. While during the northeast monsoon, during September, during January, December, November, this time, it changes its path and it moves in an anti-clockwise direction. So winds are the responsible for both the direction and the magnitude. The oceanic circulation pattern roughly corresponds to the Earth's atmospheric circulation pattern. Now if you want to see the real-time circulation pattern of the wind on the Earth, you can go to this site. This site is called earth.nullschool.net. From here we can see the entire pattern of the wind at present time. You can see, you can drag whole globe and choose the position whatever you want. So suppose if you want to see the wind speed here, just click here and you can come to know the wind velocity as well as longitude and latitude of that place. So here we can see that in the northern hemisphere, near the India, there is no cyclonic movement, while in the southern hemisphere one cyclone is here, another is here, and at the same time cyclones and anticyclones are present over whole southern hemisphere. Now if you see, in the eye of the cyclone, this point is called eye of the cyclone. If you click here, the velocity is very less, around 16-17 kilometer per hour in the center, just in the center. If you want to go like see the detail, just zoom it. It takes some time. Just click here. You can see it's very less. It's around 16-17 kilometer near the eye. If I come to know the exact place of eye, it's around 0 kilometer per hour. But near the flanks of the or wall of the cyclone, the velocity is very high. You can see here, it's 60 kilometer. It's 54 kilometer. So this means that in the eye of the cyclone, the velocity is very zero. Exact eye is zero, around zero. While on the walls, it is very high. Suppose here. Here it's 1 kilometer per hour. It's the exact eye, near to the eye. While if we click here, it's around 30 kilometer per hour. So due to a small change in the distance, you can see there is a vast difference between the velocity. So like that only, you can see the entire Earth and even on the continents, the wind velocity and the direction as well. So remember, this website is used to see the current wind speed, their surface, their direction, level, etc. So moving to the topic. Now, how gravity influence the currents? So gravity tend to pull the water down to pile and create a gradient variation. Okay, so in, we know that due to the wind circulation, all the water moves from east side of a ocean to the west side of the ocean on the equatorial regions. So we know that in the equatorial regions, easterlies moves from east to west. So it drags all the water from this position. Suppose this is the ocean, right? And here it's a eastern region, here is the western region. So and wind is moving from like this, from east to west. So it drags all the water from this position to this position. This is called western intensification. And now, due to piling of water on the western side of the ocean, all the waters come to in equilibrium. And here the gravity plays a role, because here the height of the water is more as compared to the eastern side. That this is why it is called western intensification. And due to increase in size, its potential gravitational potential energy increases. So to balance the gravitational potential energy, it moves towards the eastern region. That's why here gravity plays a role in generating the currents. And that's why on the equatorial region we have equatorial counter currents we have due to this gravity region. Now Coriolis force. How the Coriolis force influence the current? The Coriolis force cause the water to move right in the northern hemisphere and left in the southern hemisphere. These large accumulation of water and the flow around them are called gyres. These produce a large circular current in all the ocean basins. One such circular current is Sargasso Sea. Remember, Sargasso Sea is in the northern Atlantic Ocean. Now moving to the secondary forces that influence the current, the first one is the temperature difference. So let's see how the temperature difference generates the current. Okay, the difference in the water density affect the vertical mobility of ocean current. So we know that this density depends upon the salinity as well as temperature, right? More the temperature, less the density. More the salinity, more the density. The water with high salinity is denser than the water with low salinity. In the same way, cold water is denser than the warm water. Denser water tends to sink, while relatively lighter water tends to rise. Cold water ocean currents occur when the cold water at the pole sinks and slowly moves towards the equator. This is a part of a thermohaline circulation. And warm water currents travel out from the equator along the surface, flowing towards the pole to replace the sinking cold water. So due to this, there is a continuous cycle of Hot water and cold water is moving from equator to pole and pole to equator, respectively. Now moving to the next slide, that is types of ocean current. So based on depth, there are two types of ocean current, surface current and the deep current. Surface current constitute 10% of all the waters in the ocean. These waters are the upper 400 meters of the ocean. So these lie in upper 400 meter region. Okay. So remember, this is upper 400 meter. Sorry, I can't write. Okay, it's upper 400 meter for the surface current. This deep water current make up the other 90% of the ocean water, and this water moves around the ocean basin due to the variation in the density and the gravity. Deep water sink into the deep ocean basin at high latitudes where the temperature are cold enough to cause density to increase. So on the basis of depth, there are two types, surface and the deep water current. Remember, this is the 10% of the total and this is the 90%. Now based on the temperature, so based on the temperature, there are two types of current, that is cold current and the warm current. Now there is something very important related to these two types of current. So usually cold current are associated with the deserts. I will explain how cold current are associated with the deserts. See, the cold current brings the cold water into the warm areas, like from high latitudes to the low latitudes, from polar region to the equator. These currents are usually found on the west coast of the continent and east coast of the oceans. Okay, in the low and the middle latitude and on the east coast of the higher latitude in the northern hemisphere, they are normally found. Warm currents bring warm water into the cold areas, like from low to the high latitudes, for example from equator to the pole, and are usually observed on the east coast of the continent in the low and the middle latitude. In the northern hemisphere, they are found on the west coast of the continent in the high latitudes. So if we see, I can show you the map. Here we can see that around here, these all are coming from the polar region, right? We know that if the current is coming from the polar region, it is colder current, right? So this Canaries current, Bangula current, Peruvian current, California current, West Australian current, these all are coming from the poles. And if you see, all the deserts, mid latitude deserts, are found near this. See, Atacama desert is here, the Mojave desert is here, West Australian desert is here, Sahara is here. So this is the reason why cold current are associated with the deserts. Now we can see here, we can see all the major currents of the world. So let's start with the Indian subcontinent. Like here we are, this is North Equatorial Current. In between this is called Equatorial Counter Current, and this is generated by Western intensification. Here, due to the trade winds, all the water is converged over here, and the level of water rises. So to compensate the gravitational potential energy, all the waters moves towards this side, that is east of the ocean, and equatorial counter currents are generated. So remember, in every ocean we get this equatorial current, north equatorial current, equatorial counter current, and south equatorial current, like in Indian, in Atlantic, and in Pacific. Okay, see here, it's a Somali current. This current is called West Indian current, East Indian current. Now this Somali current is moving in this direction. This means this is a time of northeast monsoon. In northeast monsoon, the movement is from towards the equatorial region, and during southwest monsoon, the movement of Somali current is towards upper region, or you can say higher latitudes. Here we have Agulhas current. This current, there is another current over here that is called Mozambique current. This is called Benguela current. This is called Brazil current. And here we can see that there is a formation of subtropical gyre. So remember, in the southern hemisphere, in the northern, in the Atlantic, and in the northern hemisphere, in the Atlantic, we have this subtropical gyres. In Indian Ocean, we have only one subtropical gyre, while in Pacific, again, we have two subtropical gyres. So here we can see all kinds of current. And remember, these currents always use the nearby place. Like here Mozambique is here, that's why it is called Mozambique current. Here Agulhas region, Somalia is here, that's why it is called Somali current. Here Benguela, Brazil is here, similarly Canary current and Alaskan current. So most of the currents are on the basis of the nearby location. Now just remember some important currents, like this Gulf stream. This, it is the fastest moving current, is warmest current. And this Antarctica circumpolar current, this is ACC. It is the longest current and it covers the whole globe. It never separated or breaked. It covers the whole globe. It is the longest current. And remember, this all red currents are the warm currents and this blue currents are the cold currents. And if you see in this region, like from 0 to around 45 46 60 degree, you can see all the warm currents are on the west part of the ocean and cold currents are on the east part of the ocean. While over this above this region, above the 50 degree, you can see the warm currents are on the this side and the cold currents are on this side. So this is the important concept. You can remember this. So as the latitude rises, on the high latitudes, the warm currents are generally on the eastern side of the continents here, and the cold currents are on the western side of the ocean. So that's it. Now moving to the next slide. What is the general characteristic of the ocean currents? So the characteristic of ocean currents arises due to the interplay of the above mentioned factors. Like in general, the movement of the currents in the northern hemisphere is clockwise and in the southern hemisphere is counterclockwise, that is anticlockwise, and it is mainly due to this Coriolis force. Okay, this is due to the Coriolis force, which is a deflective force and follows the Farrell's law. What is Farrell's law? Farrell's law is something which causes the movement right in the northern hemisphere and left in the southern hemisphere to any fluid. A notable exception to this trend is seen in the northern part of the Indian Ocean, where the current movement changes its direction. So there is only one exception in the Indian Ocean. You can see here, the exception of this is here. There is a changing in the, or you can say the reversal of wind takes place and the current takes place due to this monsoon things. The warm current moves towards the cold seas and the cool current moves towards the warm seas. Okay. So here the second point is the warm current moves towards the cold sea and the cold current moves towards the warm sea. In the lower latitudes, warm currents flow on the eastern shores and the cold on the western shores. The situation is reversed in the higher latitude. The warm current moves along the western source and cold currents along the eastern source. Now there are two things happen, like one is called convergence and other is called divergence. Warm and cold currents meet, then it is called convergence. In the case of divergence, a single current splits into the multiple currents flowing into different direction. For example, you can see here this in Atlantic, it is called Gulf Stream here. And here somewhere here there is another current called Florida current. For example, here one current, this South Equatorial current breaks into two. One is Agulhas and here is Mozambique. So this is a good example of divergence. And finally, the shape and the position of coast play an important role in guiding the direction of current. So due to this shape here, this triangular shape cause breaking of the current. Now, the effects of ocean current. So the first effect is called desert formation. We already discussed about it. The cold ocean currents have a direct effect on the desert formation in the west coast region of the tropical and subtropical continents. There is a fog, and the most of the areas are arid due to this desiccating effect. Now, what is desiccation? Desiccation is nothing but the loss of moisture. Second one is rain. Now, this current is also related to the precipitation. Warm ocean currents bring a rain to the coastal areas and even interiors also. Example, summer rainfall in British type of climate. This British type of climate is a part of competent classification. We will discuss later. The warm currents flow parallel to the east coast of the continents in the tropical and subtropical latitudes. These result in the warm and the rainy climate, and these areas lie in the western margin of the subtropical anticyclones. So I will discuss it later, this in the cyclones and anticyclones. The third is moderating effect. These are also responsible for the moderating the temperature of the coast. So for example, northern Atlantic drifts bring a warmness to the England. Due to this Gulf stream, there is a warmness in the England. Canary cold current brings cooling effect to the Spain and Portugal. Then if you see this fishing, mixing of cold and warm ocean currents bear the richest fishing ground in the world. So these are part of frontal zones. Example, Greek banks around the Newfoundland, Canada, northeastern coast of Japan. You can see this fishing effect due to the mixing of cold and warm oceans or formation of fronts. The mixing of warm and cold currents helps to replenish the oxygen and favor the growth of phytoplanktons, the primary food for fish population. The best fishing grounds of the world exist mainly in the mixing zones or the frontal regions. The fifth one is drizzle. Mixing of cold and warm ocean current creates a foggy weather where the precipitation occurs in the form of drizzle. So example of this is Newfoundland. And finally, the climate. So warm and the rainy climate in the tropical and subtropical latitude are result of this thing, mixing of or due to the formation of different kinds of current around the continents. Cold and dry climates on the western margin in the subtropics is due to this desiccating effect we already discussed. Foggy weather and the drizzle in the mixing zones are found, and moderate climate along the western coasts of in the subtropicals are found. So these are the some effects of the ocean currents, and this is the image we already discussed about it. So hope you like it. Thank you very much. Please do like, comment and subscribe my channel. I will make a separate videos on upcoming days, like on cyclones, on ozone and like that only. So thank you very much.